Hello together. I'm Sebastian Kratzer, system owner for batteries at MAN. I'm very proud not only to present our new battery, but also to represent a hardworking and passionate engineering team who has worked very hard in the last years to bring this battery to the street. Battery development at MAN is core competence. For us, it's really the key challenge to bring the best battery chemistry to the street to fulfill the customer requirements, especially the vehicle range. Therefore, we have decided to develop the battery internally. The assembly of the battery system will be done by our assembly partner based on our assembly manuals. But now, let's dig into the details of the battery system. Within this big housing, we have placed the cell modules on two layers, and you can easily exchange cell modules in the service if needed. The whole compartment is closed with this aluminium cover, which is stiff but light. And the stiffness is key to safeguard the cells against any damage, like in the ECE R66 bus rollover test. Also, the absolute temperature level of the cell is very important in terms of range, vehicle performance and lifetime. So we can not only cool the battery cell, we can also heat it with an external heater in the vehicle. We also use the thick thermal isolation to avoid the battery to cool down in winter. Here in the front, what you see first is the, we call it battery junction box. This is this housing here, where we have within the box the battery electronic, and we have the low voltage interface, we have the high voltage interface. And here in the front, we see some emergency degassing valves, which in an unlikely event of a cell failure will guide the cell gas coming from the cells through the battery junction box. And in the vehicle, we further guide it away to avoid any gas intrusion to the passenger compartments to guarantee the passenger's safety. Quite early in the project, we analyzed the customer requirements like drive range, vehicle performance, and heating and cooling demands for an e-bus, and came soon to the conclusion that with existing lithium-ion technologies, we cannot fulfill these requirements. Together with the whole R&D competence of the VW Group, we pushed the limits of cell development to establish a new nickel-manganese-cobalt chemistry with a high nickel content to provide the best energy density up to date. We can benefit really from a cross-brand validation concept here and bring millions of miles of test kilometers into a robust product. This also applies for the quality assurance in cell production, where the whole VW Group is pooling its efforts to secure the quality from the mines to the complete cell. The battery management system is located down here in the central ECU, which calculates the battery cell state and controls the battery safety control devices. Battery software can be divided into two areas. One is to control the battery system and its safety. The other is to calculate the state of the battery cell. Especially the cell functions, for example, state of charge calculation, are centrally developed and tested and used in all electric vehicles within the VW Group. So we are here at the battery system test bench, which represents one aspect of battery validation. We start testing the smallest subcomponents of the battery system and further add complexity to build bigger and bigger systems to systematically validate the battery pack up to full vehicle level. Our test concept not only addressed the state of the art, meaning that all standards and regulations are fulfilled, we tested over 100,000 battery cells during the project to ensure that the battery is safe and reliable in any condition. For us, battery development is a core competence. With the current battery, we are defining the benchmark, and for the future, we will continue on this level.